Today in the news, we got storage and memory companies that think that we're dumb and AMD making our lives easier. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. In the last couple of months, we seem to have had a pretty substantial increase of bait and switches from storage manufacturers. For example, late last month, Western Digital got caught swapping the TLC memory chips from their SN550 SSD with arguably worse QLC chips. On these drives, after the cache is exhausted, the new drives would only perform at about 64% the speed of the original models with TLC chips. Not only that, but QLC memory wears out faster and is less reliable than TLC. Another manufacturer, Samsung, was also caught doing something similar. Samsung said that they have decided to upgrade the controller and NAND in the 970 EVO Plus. Once again though, after the cache has been filled up, performance of that drive tanks to about 50% of what a launch day drive from Samsung would have been. I'm not sure if that's what you would call an upgrade. Crucial was also caught doing the same with the P2 drive, this time with even worse results. When tested, the P2 can lose as much as 75% of its performance. That's worse than the two others we just talked about. I mean, look at this test here, for example. Copying a 50 gigabyte file results in speeds of 98 megabytes per second. That's worse than a hard drive. The original TLC version could do 428 megabytes per second sustained. All of those companies have essentially blamed the pandemic for their bait and switches, which honestly is pretty dumb. If the product changes, just change the product number. It's that easy. Anyways, it's a pretty big issue. Now though, we got another tactic used that could affect us consumers, but this time it's on memory. The person who brought this up is Bill Zoid from Actually Hardcore Overclocking. In his video, he found that Patriot, the memory company, has switched the specs of one of their kits silently. So they basically give you a memory kit for the same price with the same model number, but just a worse product. The kit he has is CL19 with a TRCD and TRP of 19. So in spec speak, it would be 19, 19, 19, and 39. The kits sold now are CL18, which seems better, but the rest of the timings are worse. It's 18, 22, 22, 42. Now, you might ask, who the hell cares? Somebody will buy this and the specs are clearly visible, so that's not a problem, right? Well, yeah, but memory is often under warranty for years, or in Patriot's case, for life. And when you have an issue and you send your kits to Patriot, guess what you're gonna receive back? Yep, the new, worse model. Not only that, but think about reviewers. If I had to review this kit when it came out, it would have had a specific set of results. And now the new version is completely differently spec'd, so these results won't match, which means the reviewers gets hit because it seems like a liar, and of course the consumer gets hit because if they buy it with my review recommendation, they're gonna get a worse product. So that was Patriot. Now the second culprit is Corsair. They thought that it was a good idea to simply ignore the rest of the timings. They just list the tested cache latency and that's it. That's the first of four numbers. Not listing the timings essentially prevents you from knowing what you're getting, since it's fairly easy to identify what manufacturer, like Samsung or Micron, makes the memory based on the timings. This behavior really needs to stop, whether it be for storage or for memory. And it looks like it did. Editing Snows here, and it looks like thanks to the Build Zoid video and a couple of other YouTubers that I know reached out to Corsair, they reverted back to showing the entire tested latency. So that's a small win. Let's not stop here. It's fairly easy, just make everything public. Anytime you make a change, tell people, release a press release. Next up, we got AMD. The company just released its update to the Adrenaline driver and software package. This update includes, as usual, software and bug fixes, improvements in certain games, but it also includes three new cool things. First of all, is official support for Windows 11. While the old drivers could be installed, this one is the first officially supported one by AMD. The second thing is resizable bar support for our X 5000 series of GPUs. So if you have a 5000 series, well, you can see an increase in FPS thanks to SAM, or Smart Access Memory. And the last thing is probably the best. Don't want to take the time to tweak your CPU or GPU for an overclock? Well, this version will bring an auto overclocker feature. It only works with Ryzen 5000 series CPUs and RX 6000 series GPUs, but it's a pretty good one-click feature. For the CPU, it will increase clocks by increments of 50 megahertz until it reaches its thermal limit. As for the GPU, well, it will simply just boost it past its specifications. I wonder if the auto OC feature will be better than Rage Mode, or if they will both complement themselves. It'll be interesting to see what other people have to say, since I'm sure somebody like Gamers Nexus is going to make an hour and a half long video about it. And that's pretty much it for the catch-up, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Drop a like if you liked it, a comment if you want to talk about today's stories. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care.